All right, so we got about 50 minutes and you guys got lunch break. Came down last night. Probably one of the more innovative technicians that I've been around in a long time. Up at Cornell now, working with their RTC guys. Energy's a little bit better now, so hopefully we carry that into lunch and then come back from lunch and continue with that. But Corey Cooperman, no stranger to this area, but again, like I said, his technique, his innovation, the way he thinks about it, obsesses about wrestling, something I respect at an extremely high level, so I'll start
to keep going on those things. All right, guys. I'm going to be speaking fast. We got less than an hour. I'm going to try to get a lot done. Maybe like 2, 3, 4 turns on top, and then we'll get on our feet. Okay? I saw Coach Santo working on top, and I'm a big proponent of being good on top, right? Especially if you're playing on wrestling in college, you get that riding time point, right? So it's a difference maker, okay? So you can give up a takedown in a match, still win. He gets a takedown first period, I get out, it's 2-1, I choose bottom, I get out, it's 2-2, he chooses bottom, I ride him. Riding time point, I win the match 3-2. It's a difference maker, right? Everybody at the Division 1 level, Division 2, Division 3, those guys are all going to be good on their feet. Everybody works on their feet, right? It's a difference maker being good on top, right? When I was in high school, in Russell, St. Ed's, those guys from Ohio, they're taught me to wrestle on your feet, and we'd win the match right here. You see an NCAA semifinals, quarterfinals, big match. You win the next match, you're in the semifinals, you're in the national finals. We're in double overtime. Guy stands up, cuts him, right? Effort. After 30 seconds, you keep him down, you're in the national finals. You're giving yourself a chance to be an national champ, right? But it's that effort. Guy just stands up, and the guy's cut him, right? So my philosophy on top is, if we're looking to turn guys, they're just looking to stay off their back, and we will ride them. We'll get that point if we don't turn them, right? If we're looking to ride them, right, then we're following, they're dictating, and I'll be the one getting tired, and we're most likely going to be getting out. I'm going to be moving fast, stay focused. I've been in your shoes. I've been in your situation. Coach is sitting, teaching. You're sitting there. Your mind is somewhere else. Be focused. In my opinion, I'm going to show some good stuff. I could be going over all on our feet, but I think I can show you guys a couple things that you can pick up, take home with you, and hopefully it's a difference maker in your wrestling. Okay? So, getting started. Forward pressure, right? I like to think of the inverse in wrestling. So this guy wants me behind him so that he can get his hands off the mat, get his chest perpendicular to the mat, and be standing up. So if he wants me behind him, where do I want to be? Out to the side, right? I want to be getting weight on his hands. I want that forward pressure. For me, one of two ways. Either a double thigh tie, or I'm going off with this one, double thigh tie, running my feet and lay on his hands, or where I like to go, spiral by, prime the thigh, plus one arm out. Okay? We're going to start off with a single wrist. It's my favorite turn, and I score a lot of points here. Okay? So I'm going to start off spiral by, and this guy's not going to be moving. He's going to be basing out, being real strong, and I'm going to do what I call an inside chop. Okay? So, start with spiral, you can go anywhere, and I'm going to use my hand to bend the elbow, and I'm going to do that chop. Boom. Here. I'm not grabbing the wrist, but I'm just going to roll that out. And I'm going to grab what I call the blade of his hand, right here. Right here. Again, spiral right, go anywhere, inside chop, and I get the blade of his hand. Okay? Now, from here, pay attention to all these details. We've got a lot of moving parts. So my back knee is in front, pushing back. Okay? I'm going to pull his arm up and table it here. And you see we're elbow to elbow? If I'm elbow to elbow, he's going to look for turning, right? Knee sliding, put me back behind him. Now I'm going to be in trouble. He's going to be coming up. Okay? I want my back knee pushing back, and I'm going to go from elbow to elbow, head elbow to shoulder. So from here, to the back of the shoulder. Okay? My back here is pushing back, and I call this base position. Right? When I'm in this position, my back knee is in front, pushing back, elbow to elbow, elbow to shoulder. Right? I feel strong, and I don't think this guy's going to be going too far. Okay? So from here, and this is where I really want you guys to get out there, get in this position. And if I'm running a practice, a lot of times I'll say, get here, and then tell your partner, try to get out. okay? And you know, people give you different looks, right? So my back knee pushing back, elbow in the shoulder. I want you guys to see something real quick. I let go of this wrist. I let go of this wrist. And I'm going to slide my arm in here, flip it up. And that's the same exact pressure, right? It's the same exact pressure as a bar, and we're going to look to run it like a bar, okay? So my back knee pushing back, not elbow to elbow, elbow to shoulder. And I'm going to use my hip behind his elbow, right? And look to drive like with his shoulder angle here, elbow on my back. So one more time, we go out there for a minute or two, come right back in. Inside chop, blade in his hand, back knee is in front. Not gonna say elbow to elbow, where am I going? Elbow to shoulder, let's have some more pop right now, okay? Elbow to shoulder, here. If he's keeping height, you know, if he's keeping some height, maybe I just chop with his elbow, right? Bust him, but I want to be here. Again, keeping my back knee in front, he's gonna be looking to rotate his knee, he's gonna try to get his knee back in front of mine, right? Like I said before, he wants to look to turn in and all that stuff. If you're elbow to elbow, that will happen. But with the elbow to shoulder, I'm keeping that pressure down, okay? My hip is driving, it was warm. And that's what's gonna give you that bar-like pressure. Any questions? You ready to play? On two, one, two.